and MCQs. So first part of the topic, viral keratitis, it is generally caused by herpes simplex virus, both type 1 and type 2, and herpes zoster virus. Viral keratitis symptoms. So as for any inflammation, there will be pain and redness. Apart from that, in the eye, it will lead to photophobia, watering, and defective vision. Defective vision depending on the location of the lesion. For example, in this picture, it's a slit lamp picture of the cornea with the cobalt blue filter. This shows the typical viral corneal lesion in the center. So in these cases, definitely there will be defective vision. If the viral lesions are in the periphery, there may not be defective vision. Apart from the defective vision, there will be redness, congestion, pain, photophobia, and watering. What are the signs of viral keratitis? Again, it can be either in the epithelial layer or stromal layer. If it is in the epithelial layer, it can take up the stain like this. If it is not in the epithelial layer, the cornea will not take up the stain. For example, in stromal keratitis, you will see a stromal edema, or it can be a disciform keratitis. In herpes zoster ophthalmicus, the signs are slightly different. Apart from the corneal or ocular signs, there will be cutaneous signs also, which we will discuss subsequently. This picture shows rose Bengal stain ulcer to your left, and a fluorescein stained ulcer, extensive corneal lesion arranged centrally to your right side. This picture shows sterile immune ring. It is in the stroma because of the body's response to the viral infection. So you are seeing a sterile immune ring, the left side picture. Here the cornea will not take up stain. And one more sign, you can see the circumcorneal congestion. The left side picture, again you can see a fluorescein stain ulcer. How will you diagnose with the investigations? Investigation generally will have to do viral culture, but which is not needed in cases of viral keratitis, because viral keratitis is generally diagnosed clinically. The clinical signs are very important to elicit, and it is generally diagnosed clinically only. For academic purposes, you can do corneal scraping and do viral culture. Once it is diagnosed, how will you treat? You treat with 3% acyclovir IR ointment 5 times a day for 2 weeks, or 0.15% ganciclovir IR ointment 3 times a day for 2 weeks. If it is extensive, you can add oral acyclovir. What are the complications if it is not treated properly? It can lead to neurotrophic keratitis, because the virus will damage the corneal nerves, leading to the neurotrophic keratitis or corneal ulcer. In corneal ulcer, it may lead to corneal scarring and defective vision. And the inflammation can spread to the uvea, causing uveitis and inflammatory glaucoma. And it can perforate also. And this picture clearly shows the herpes zoster ophthalmicus. Apart from affecting the eye per se, it affects the skin around the eye. Basically, it affects the same dermatome where the trigeminal nerve supplies. I think we all know that trigeminal nerve supplies cornea also. Okay. That the ala of the nose and the tip of the nose is affected, and there are more chances, around 70-80% chances, that cornea is also affected. So this particular sign is called Acheson sign. Whenever we see the tip of the nose and the ala of the nose affected with this type of lesions, we need to check the cornea for any lesions. There are more chances that cornea is also affected. What is the reason for that? Same nerve supply. This is the picture showing trigeminal nerve. As we discussed in That's the simplest keratitis. Here also it can be either epithelial keratitis, stromal keratitis, or it can lead to scleritis or episcleritis, or multiple cranial nerve palsies depending on where the virus is affecting. Treatment same, but here we need to put on the patient with oral antiviral agents. Oral azathioprine 800 milligrams 5 times a day for 5 days with or without topical azathioprine. If the cardia is not affected, then you can just prescribe any lubricants. The next part of today's talk is protozoal keratitis. Out of the protozoal keratitis, we are going to discuss about acanthamoeba keratitis. Acanthamoeba is a protozoa which can affect the eyes due to various reasons. Basically, it is very difficult to diagnose and very, very difficult to treat. Because it is very difficult to diagnose, the diagnosis is commonly delayed for weeks to months. By the time it is diagnosed, it might have led to more complications, irreversible complications. There is no appropriate treatment method as of now, but still, once it is diagnosed, we need to treat to prevent life-threatening complications. But prevention is better than cure. Factors are the etiology. It is typically found in contact lens wearers. Daily wear or extent of any type of contact lenses, they are prone to the second type of keratitis if the proper sterilization and storage techniques are not followed. In addition to that, if there is history of corneal trauma or history of bathing in a swimming pool or history of ocular exposure to non-sterilized water or liquids, so these are the risk factors where we can have acanthamoeba keratitis. So any patient coming to ophthalmology clinic with redness and history of contact lens wear or history of bathing in a swimming pool, first thing to rule out is acanthamoeba keratitis. How will you rule out acanthamoeba keratitis? Symptoms. Here the symptoms is out of proportion to the clinical findings. Okay. In frontal corneal ulcer, the findings are more than the symptoms. Here the symptoms are more than the findings. Okay. If at all we see any findings, the findings are stromal ring infiltrate or radial keratoneuritis. This picture shows the central stromal ring infiltrate. How will you confirm the diagnosis? By doing investigations such as corneal scraping for smear and culture, and with copper fluoride white stain, and culture in a non-nutrient agar with E. coli, or through confocal microscopy to visualize the cysts and trophozoites. Treatment with the topical antiemulsifiers. It is very difficult to obtain these medical agents and prepare in the correct concentration, and long-term therapy to eradicate the cyst. And how will you prevent? Obviously, the proper contact lens disinfection methods and care is very important step. The treatment depends on the availability of the amygdalocellulose and the method of preparation. What are those? Those are biguanides, dexamidines, imidazoles. In biguanides, PHMB, polyhexamethylene biguanide, 0.1% is useful for this acanthamoeba keratitis. And other agents are benzamidines, propamidine 0.1%, and imidazole such as miconazole and clotrimazole, each 1%, it can be used as ointment also, drops also are available. But the response is very less and the prognosis is grave in cases of acanthamoeba keratitis, leading to blinding complications. That is all for today's class. Today we saw about viral keratitis caused by herpes simplex virus 1 and 2 and herpes zoster virus, followed by acanthamoeba keratitis